I mean, follow my socials.
Hi, beautiful people. April 7th.
Nobunaga sensei no Osanazuma. Comedy with time traveling? Probably a harem? This one is short too, 7 minutes.
Light.
Spoilers, really?
Yeah.
There's clearly some work done to make the characters look prettier, but we have really uninteresting designs. The only really interesting is the fiancé.
Yeah.
And production mistakes. A good amount of time of the fiancé's presence, her eyes looks like they were in the wrong position, or maybe in the wrong proportions, I'm not really sure. And honestly, the premise is not really well presented. From the opening that they did in the end,
paradox!
It looks like it's going to become a harem. And with the main character being so empty, it certainly looks like it. Let the rock roll, I have to talk about the horrible idea they had. Main character is a teacher. He doesn't have a girlfriend and they are pressuring him to get married. His name is Nobunaga Oda. So for a while, I thought that there were historical jokes that I just wasn't getting because they are not so common for me. But no, it's a story about a time traveler. The fiancé of the original Nobunaga, who's 15. Medieval times. And is literally a lolly throwing herself at him. But it's not enough that all of this is horrible and complicated. She has a moment of saying, I'm a child, but I'm not going to be tricked by you. So while for a second they seem to be getting a mind from that time and putting in hours to talk seriously about this and have a justification of why you are saying these things... It's a comedy. And if you have any doubts about the production having problems, look at the chibis. They are not SD like most, they are practically stick figures. So in this not at all work that world, the descendant of Nobunaga Oda sees a teacup broken and gets a fiancé from the past who wants nothing but to get married to him. Physically! There's a reason why people think a kid wanting to get married to an adult is cute. Because nobody believes it's actually going to happen. If you are talking about a 14-year-old, it's much more complicated than this. And the worst part is, I am sure they know about the problem, because otherwise he would not have had that moment of, I am a child, but you won't trick me. It's almost as bad as Tenshin Ii Mayorita. But that's it. What did you think of this episode? Leave it on the comments, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye. And if you enjoyed it, please like, share, sub to the channel, and hit that bell.